touch their wheels twice. They must either pass or shoot or dribble. That's what keeps the ball and the play active, or otherwise it's a traveling call against. The play comes in, it goes right off the glass a little too aggressively, not coming off the hands of Jamie Jules, a 27-year-old for Canada. So four 10-minute periods in wheelchair basketball, just as it is in the Olympic sport basketball as well. And this, a little bit of pause the moment before a shot. Oh, and it's a beauty. Did it get in just before time? And they will count it. And Great Britain quickly out with 4 points on the board. Canada again with the attempt and just a little too forceful, and it goes off the rim, and there is the British athlete just trying to get righted there. And that's Claire Griffiths, and she's a 1.5 in her classification. So for those just new to Paralympic sport, each athlete with a classification based on their level of function, and the lower the level or the numerical value associated with your classification means the less level of function. So you have five players on the floor each side and a total value of 14. And to give you an indication, the highest you might have in your lineup is a 4.5 and the lowest you might have is a 1.0. So how you put together your lineup based on your strengths and your players that will most likely carry the offensive load, and then your other key components as well, that is the coaching tactic in any Paralympic sport, and equally wheelchair basketball the same. This one almost looked to have fallen over the front of the rim, but again, it is Great Britain who are holding court at the moment, and they have taken this early lead, and again, with possession. This is their captain, Helen Freeman. This one will go off the bar. The long pass and the transition game from Canada. That is fantastic body control to receive that at the far end. Cindy Ouellette, the captain as well, the two co-captains of Canada, and a rough ride in there for the other one, Janet McLaughlin. And both of those athletes, McLaughlin a 4.5 and Ouellette a 3.5 in their classification in this sport. So the foul coming in the course of the shot, or just prior rather, so it'll just be an inbound now. McLaughlin, as you see, quite high in her chair, a little bit of a different position for her as far as just the height. Equally, she has the length from her seat through her torso, an advantage she'll have for rebounding, and that's where she generally will find herself, in and amongst that basket area and underneath it. But now to be inbounded for Canada, and Kenny Hardock, the 33-year-old, into Cindy Ouellette again. Ouellette 27, and that one goes up. And it's in for Canada. Well, they've taken a few moments here, just that 3-minute mark, to get themselves on the board, but a miss by Great Britain, and the two, Ouellette and McLaughlin, the two real front runners with most of the possession as far for Canada. The feed in, a good drive to the basket, and a couple times you've seen maybe just a little bit strong off the window there. It'll kick out again, and Great Britain will just weave and wind. Both teams playing at a pretty good clip so far, and as happy to extend each other with their speed. That long pass from the Canadians, though, really a great moment of athleticism and control to have taken it underneath the basket. But this is a steal by Canada. The return and a quick basket is put in. Cindy Ouellette will score for the Canadians. And this now a level match in the first period. Just 4 minutes gone now. Great Britain throwing on the brakes. You need to really be as capable of passing the ball with both hands. And equally the left and the right hand, because you're never really entirely prepared for how the defense may line up against you, or which way, in fact, you need to find and direct yourself in a different channel towards the basket. or in an opening to make a play, but it's going to be the Canadians with the inbound here now. It's been turned over. And this into the safe hands of McLaughlin. 39 years of age is McLaughlin, a veteran, but in this sport, you see them capable of playing on, and now Canada with the lead. A very delicate touch up and over, and Katie Harnock has put it on the board. So it's a balance so far. Nitsulet with a couple points. Harnock now with her first basket. And Great Britain go off the rim. McLaughlin attempting to get the rebound there, and it will come off of her hand and out of play. So 4 points already, as we say, for the captain. As we look at the British side, the scoring so far, Freeman with a couple points and Conroy as well. It's a timeout for both sides to take a little bit of a pause. And that's always one of the challenges coming in, that first match of a major competition like this, the Paralympic Games. Generally, you see the teams just kind of sounding themselves out and trying to find a measure, being a little bit cautious. But both of these teams just as happy to up the pace and take their chances when they come. And this is the Canadian coach, Bill Johnson from Winnipeg. He's been involved with this program since 2009 as the head coach, assistant coach for 3 seasons prior. As you mentioned, his brother Joey Johnson, a star of the Canadian men's national team as well. Look there, you see the shot leading up, and you see a lot of that. You see that in a lot of sport equally. It's a family affair, a lot of crossover and participation, and they will no doubt be keeping an eye on each other's performances as the camaraderie and now the spirit is alive and well in the first day of competition. It's in. Great Britain are given the outside at the moment to have a look to see if they want to take a shot. But Canada give too much of a lane and entry there. This the offload and just a little bit of the skyhook over the top, but it can't fall for Great Britain. And the speed coming away again. Ouellette. And the Canadians looking more comfortable into McLaughlin. She goes right off the glass and in. Those her 4 points, or her first rather, and they're now 4 points in the lead. Great Britain have seen some daylight right through, finding the right angle towards the basket and the left hand. It's up and in for Ellen Freeman, the 26-year-old. So back again. Within 2 points. So 3 from 7 so far in their shooting range, and there from the outside. Canada starting to find their mark, and McLaughlin, the tower of power, showing the touch of a surgeon there as she finds her second basket of the game. Freeman, as we say, it's just the shooting percentage at the moment for Great Britain. It's okay, and there's another one. They're at 50% now. That's 4 from 8, and giving them the total of 8 points. No free throws as yet for either side, and equally no 3-point attempts as yet either. Just stepping into a lane. There was some room. The rebound, what a glorious push in there from the Canadian number 8. That was Rosalie Lalonde, 19 years of age, and she takes her first shot of these Paralympic Games. Looking for a substitution. But they're just gonna hold for a moment. They'll allow this play to continue, but no, they'll allow it in. And Great Britain have brought in Jordana Bartlett. She's 21, a 3.0 classification. And a cheer now sounding around this fabulous venue in Rio's Olympic Park. The offload and given. Little wrap up there. And down is McLaughlin. And you see the work they do to get themselves upright again. Whether or not they'll need to come out and just sort of dry the floor up there a little bit. It looks okay. But that's all a part of it. And these athletes are just as happy to make sure they look after their own business. They're very self-sufficient, as you might expect. Here they come, though. This is Great Britain in control. The safe possession of Helen Freeman. The pass, the offload up, and that almost falling. This one, the rebound, and sensational work there just to see that followed through by Amy Conroy. She's 23. And now, with that four-point margin for Canada, it's evaporated. And we're level at 10. And it's just coming up to 2 minutes remaining in this first quarter. Canada off the rim. You can hear the rigidity of that rim. It was seen really in the Olympic Games as being quite flexible. With this, it's a little bit more taut now. And you can see the way the ball is bouncing off of it. Hear it equally. And the players need to allow for that as well. So Freeman for Great Britain now with 6 points. Conroy with four, and 2 points to Carrigill. The Canadians, the shot there, McLaughlin. She's starting to find her range. And she has now leading this side with 6 points. She's 3 from 4 with her field goal percentage as yet. Ouellette with 4 points. Harnock with two, and that a long pass. It'll just get away from the intended recipient, Conroy, again. So Miles Thompson, the British coach, he the American, as he said, involved with the American program previously, and a coach in the States for his club basketball. And he's got the women's national program, the under 25, under his remit now in Great Britain. And for Conroy, she will hold up just inside his three-point line, inside this last minutes, and these are just moments of trying to stake advantage at the end of the first quarter. They'll want to get a basket from the reference. That's a great play, maybe not in a perfect position. Three defenders there, and again, Great Britain come up with it. But there you see Janet McLaughlin high and up and over. The feed one more time. Look at this from Canada. The pass almost seemed to be a little short. The shot may be a little bit hard, but Cindy Ouellette, she would know better. And she finds the bottom of the basket once again. Canada in the lead. Can Great Britain just throw up a little bit of a buzzer beater here? They'll need to be on point almost. It looks, it'll come short. This will be too far in which to really get a shot there, and it will just come underneath its range. But the Canadians, who fell down by 4 points in the opening quarter, will in fact sit with a 2-point lead at the end of 10 minutes of play. It is Canada 14, Great Britain 12 points. And this, the wheelchair basketball competition, the women's division. And this is Pool A in the preliminary round. The first day in Rio. And you see some of the great scenes as well of the dancing entertainment too. So this, a beautiful venue right in the heart of the Olympic Park. Canada 14, Great Britain 12 at the end of the first quarter. So there's a look at the shooting so far. Great Britain operating at 40%. The Canadians just a shade under. And the defensive rebounds with the 9 of them, Great Britain, that's a good stat. 3 offensive rebounds as well. So showing that they are equally following up with their due diligence in and around underneath the basket. They're the signature colors, so many beautiful colors in this part of the world, as these shots of the opening quarter. And there, the long range shot, and really is impressive just how well and how accurate the athletes are. This is entirely the same court and dimensions has played in basketball. And these two teams putting on a show. Start of the second quarter. It's the Canadians with a two-point advantage. And up in the first defensive rebound for Canada. And a little bit of a new look in their lineup in the second quarter. Erin Young now with the ball. She's the 20-year-old, but this to Ouellette, the co-captain. And Ouellette has got a hot hand right now. She has just found the bottom of the basket once again, and she is as comfortable from range, that sort of 10 to 15 feet, 10, 12 feet really from the basket, just to stop and pop. And she scoring again. This the offload right at the top at that free throw line. Take it there. It's as good a shot as you're maybe going to have. It's often the case, isn't it? Preparing for what you anticipate to be a better shot, a better look, and making those decisions that you must take what's available when it's there. Canada with another good defensive rebound, and they seem to really be finding a measure, and they're going to count that as a traveling. So two pushes on the wheel before either bouncing or making a pass. And that will lead to the change of possession and the turnover. And now Great Britain right under Canada's basket. The feed centrally. Conroy has been good in front. She does it again for GB. And she now with the 3 from 5. Has got these 6 points for her own individual stats in this one. Brought it back, as you see, within two. Ouellette again. You would not doubt. And Conroy now given responsibility to try and mark her. But if she's going to give a chance, she might very well go with it. Good control from Conroy with that right hand to make sure she didn't double touch and change the ball into her opposite hand and then equally touch the wheels again. So that's always in consideration, needing to be able to play the ball with both hands and equally propel themselves with their hand on the wheel of their wheelchair. It's just tremendous consideration all the time, but it becomes natural when you do it as often as these ladies. There you see almost a incidental contact, but you'll see as well, and they do fall rather aggressively equally, but that's part of their using their natural momentum to try to get upright as well. That is the athletic nature that is these athletes. But there's substitutions for Canada, as they'll put some new energy out onto the floor. Ouellette will take receipt of the inbound. She elects just to let it fall onto her hands before starting the shot clock. And she now, great protector of the ball. McLaughlin high out at the top of the key. She's not being allowed to get into the key area by Conroy. So a part of the tactics, McLaughlin, who has a height and size advantage over all of the athletes on the floor in this matchup, being kept at bay. GB across the line, the feed in, and the fallen Canadian down. And for the first look of action, it's Tamara Stevens who will come in. Keeping a cool head so far is Bill Johnson. But this Tamara Stevens, 26 years of age, and she's a 1.5 is her level, or her classification, rather. So if you're just tuning in to Paralympic sport in general, each athlete do have an individual customized rating or classification for their level of function, and that's how they cumulatively compile the overall 14 points that are allowed on the floor at any one time between the five players. This will be broken up, though, by Great Britain. They will receive it And it's another steal and a chance for them to reassert themselves in the lead. They had it early in the first quarter, gave it up in a, ultimately in the latter stages of it, but this a chance for Ouellette to take it the other way. And it's a two-on-one. She gets bumped, though, from behind. And they will allow that to be continuous play. The whistle came early. And it looks as though the officials will have waved that one off, not allow it to be a continuous play and allow the shot. But it's quite easy for the referees. Once the wheels, either the front or the back, leave the floor, they know then that the contact that has been made, there's a level of incidental contact allowed, but if you're bumping each other to that degree, that is in fact a foul. But this is a fast break for Great Britain, and Freeman will take the 3 points and roll it around the rim. Great Britain with the lead again. So 8 points in total, 4 from 7 is Freeman, co-captain for GB. And McLaughlin needs to have a little rethink as to how she would like to attack this opportunity for the Canucks. That will go off of the back of the rim and up off the glass. And Great Britain, who have been rebounding so well in this matchup, take another little bit of control off the missed shot from the Canadians. There you see 16-11. GB with the advantage, and those are important stats over the course of the 40 minutes of action. So the inbound now for Canada. And it's going to be a timeout here. And a utilization of a 30-second window. Those are generally our momentum shifts. Canada with the lead coming into the quarter have now given that back up, and hence the opportunity for Bill Johnson is to utilize his first timeout of the match and have a little bit of a rethink and a little bit of a moment of collective thought for Canada. So you hear that there? He says our first pass can't be 3 feet off the baseline fundamentals. So basically saying they need to create further distance from wherever the ball is coming in from the sidelines, in and onto the court, onto the field of play, in order to set up the next movement that they're trying to generate. As it makes it easy to defend if your first pass is only 3 feet from the baseline, player ends up getting forced back out of bounds and giving up possession. And equally, you don't have an angle in which to make the next pass. And so that's the thoughts there coming in from Johnson, just talking about the fundamentals and the basics that need to be executed at a high level all the time. The play to the inside, the feed was good. It looked as though it was touched, maybe the hand on the way up, or not getting full control of it. There was Tamara Steves. And Great Britain, under the leadership of this lady right here, Helen Freeman, has really spearheaded this GB attack. Her and Conroy, who has the ball now. They have really been double teaming that basket so far. But that was contact between the chairs prior to the shot. And you see the indication from our referee today, Celine Villard. And our umpires, Maurizio Zamponi and Juan Magallanes, the two in support as well. But to the inside, this is Freeman, that left-handed delivery, she's not able to make it. And a couple fouls we see, but the quick hands from Great Britain, able just to knock that away. So you've got to be quick here. You're the referee just talking about 5 seconds in which to inbound it. And then equally needing to get it up over the center line as well. And then the shot clock is fully rolling. There are the seconds. They will reset the clock, though, with that attempt. So it doesn't need to hit the rim. That one did, but doesn't have to. It just needs to leave your hand with the attempt for a shot, for the resetting of the shot clock. So Hammer is in, Judith Hammer, a 4.0 and 25-year-old now to offer some strength and some new energy to Great Britain's lineup. From here, they're going to want to just maintain this lead and love to take it into the halftime interval. Conroy is out. She has been dangerous so far, Conroy. 8 points. She and Freeman are the joint leaders in scoring for Great Britain. And it's Ouellette with 8, and McLaughlin with 6 that lead the Canadians. Now coming in, Melanie Houghton, number 15. With her first bit of action. The left hand of Freeman, even from the right side, is just as comfortable. She finds the range once again. Quite measured here. They're looking to take away McLaughlin and Ouellette, and they're going to leave that shot there. And they were believing that Harnack maybe wasn't as confident as McLaughlin or Ouellette might have been, and they gave her all of that room. And you see it just went off the front of the rim and beyond. So the tactical game going on now from GB, trying to take away the strikes from this Canadian lineup. As it's McLaughlin up to Ouellette. Well, there's a sweet touch from the tall lady for Canada. And she just feathers that one over the front of the rim and cuts it back within two. Just a little bit of a rough ride coming into that, the heart of that Canadian defense, the teeth of it. And McLaughlin likes the long pass. It's a big baseball-like throw up to Ouellette. And these two are on the mark again. That fast break opportunity has leveled this one at 20. And you hear the excitement coming from the Canadian support and faithful here. That is a dangerous play in which to try and keep tabs on. And so effective, too, with that long pass. McLaughlin, she's like the Hightower of this sport, and she uses that height and length to really periscope up and over all of the field of play and find the opening down to Ouellette. So being aggressive offensively and use their speed. They talk about some of the visual cues that they have seen prior to the match and the things they need to do well. Nothing like learning from seeing others or equally yourselves when you've been playing at your best as a positive affirmation of what you need to do when you get back out onto the stage that is this opening match in the women's wheelchair basketball from Rio, the Paralympic Games. This, again, just where the Brits would like to have the basketball, but that's a challenge shot from that range there for Helen Freeman. It'll just go off the rim. And Canada with a little bit of the momentum now been generated, coming back from being down 4 points to level it. That long strike breakaway taken from Ouellette on the long feed from her teammate McLaughlin. And this McLaughlin doesn't have a lot of trajectory in that shot, though, McLaughlin. She's happy to put it forward. She's happy and believing in the accuracy. But Great Britain will strike again in the transition. And up to Laurie Williams. And Williams with her first basket of the match. So this, a two-on-one, is it going to be a feat? There is the perfect position of McLaughlin and a foul on the play, too. So she has the first opportunity for a three-point play. And she's going to go to the line here now. And the British coaches now having a chat about it. And that is Miles Thompson and Daniel Price. Price there was the one just getting involved to encourage that offensive attacking style. And Canada will now nose ahead with just the 1 point as a result of that free throw drop by McLaughlin. Freeman has taken this one all the way up the floor. She has run in, and they're going to count that one as an offensive foul. So again, the indication of that was the way the back of her chair came up as she collided into the Canadian. The suggestion that she wasn't in full control and that the Canadian player had already established position. And the chair coming up suggests that it was, in fact, maybe Freeman who needed to control herself better in that instance. And that led to the change of possession here now. Into the key. You see the majority of the shot taking coming from that lady now, McLaughlin. She will continue, and she's now taken the scoring leading for Canada. And that is Janet McLaughlin, 39 years of age, and she is one of these high levels of function. She's a 4.5, and now 13 points for Canada. So over half of the offense, but then Freeman. She has that real soft left-hand touch. She keeps this, and it's a turnover. Conroy back out there too, the offload here. Great Britain more aggressive as per their instructions from their coach. They're going to hold up though and just spin and look for another option. Conroy with great control, switching her hands and into her teammate once more. This for Freeman. Freeman has set. Freeman from the outside, and her line was great. Her depth, however, wasn't quite enough. And McLaughlin is happy to offload it. The 1-2 feed, is it going to be kept in? That's going to really be impressive. It's going to just get beyond the grasp of Canada. And chasing down a ball, and your wheels are almost in the lead too. So as soon as you do get there, you've got to be so precise with the front of your chair particularly in getting down and retrieving it, picking it up into control. So this is the last possession of the half. Or is it going to be now? Can Canada strike quickly here? They're really going to make hay now. And they've got to work quick, but it isn't back time. It's just evaporated, and it's going to be Canada who have been able to come back from being down at 4 points and nosed ahead by the one. And that really, in essence, is the free throw shot taken by McLaughlin there, number five. That is the 1 point differential. 14 points to 12 in the first quarter and 12 points to 11 in the second quarter. But it's Canada at halftime with the 25 to 24 lead over Great Britain. So there you see it, confirmation of the score. Group A action, Great Britain 24, Canada 25. As we prepare to move into the third quarter of the women's wheelchair basketball coming up. There we look at a couple attempts each, one from the three-point line. The free throws, just the one for Canada. They make full complement of it. The defensive rebound starting to measure out more equally, and so the field goal shooting percentage for both of these sides. It looks as though it's going to go deep, this one, right to the wire, and it should really, as you look at where they finished 4 years ago in the Paralympics in London, sixth and seventh place respectively. This is a battle in their right weight class, shall we say, is the best description. And the Rio faithful getting energized on day one. This is a Group A preliminary match, and the first match of the wheelchair basketball overall and in the women's. Freeman with 12 points in that first half, as good defensively as she was offensively. And McLaughlin taking care of the offense equally for the Canadians. She with 13 points and Ouellette with 10. Conroy, she's really the second weapon with 8 points on Great Britain's side. And it's going to really be about trying to get more of the game distributed offensively. Just the four scorers for GB in the opening half of play, and the Canadians not much of a difference either. They just have the three different scorers so far. So of 12 players on each team, you really are leaning heavily on your players that are going to carry the offensive load for you. And at the moment, it's McLaughlin just with this side's nudge ahead by one. She with 17 minutes and 51 seconds played in the opening half of play. Ouellette with the full 20 minutes played for Canada. And it's Freeman, she equally with the full 20 minutes played in that opening half. And Conroy, her number two, with 18:07 of the 20 total minutes played. So ready to start the second half of play. The Canadians with the one-point lead and to inbound from the sideline. The opening bit of control is their number seven again. Cindy Ouellette, 27 years of age, just makes a good spin trying to get away from the defense into the soft touch of McLaughlin. And she'll increase this Canadian margin now by 3 points. Just there from Conroy. She can't find the returned answer from Great Britain. But they'll apply a little bit more pressure in the backcourt now, trying to force Canada to have to work a little bit harder to advance this ball. Ouellette is given some daylight here. From this range, she'll shoot. And again, she's used all of the rim and found a way in which to drop it again for another Canadian bucket. So in the opening minute already, this forcing the need to call a timeout, Great Britain, as they have just given up the 4 points quickly and can ill afford now in the business half of this match to let the scoreline start to slip away from them. It's already 5 points. You see the free scoring so far. It is Helen Freeman with the 12 points, Conroy 8, and Williams 2. McLaughlin leading the way for Canada. And they really, it's ultimately going to come down to a little bit of that secondary scoring, you sense. It puts a lot of pressure on the top two scorers, really, to carry the load, but equally they're capable of it. This for Conroy. Oh, she'll find it right at the bottom of the mesh there. No touch. It's a perfect swish. And this, a timeout strategically called by Great Britain, and they respond well to come out and equally get that first bucket. Just waiting and winding. This will be that free hand of their third shooting option for Canada so far, Katie Harnack. And there from the outside, just the shot clock just expiring as you heard it sound. With the rebound for Great Britain. Some great speed here. Poise from the backside into the front. McLaughlin just sees it leave her grasp, and it just leaves out to the bottom of the baseline. It will be Great Britain now with the inbound. So to and fro, but Canada right now with a chance to really take control with a good defensive sequence here. The hand up and around the rim. Can they get the rebound? They do. Ouellette is stripped, though. Freeman takes it right from her, and she's a little more hungry. Didn't quite see her coming around the backside. And now for Freeman. Into Conroy, using the glass. McLaughlin, you expect, is in a good position there to rebound, and this a real hunt for possession. Both sides. And who touches it last? Great Britain do a tremendous job to keep that in play. Freeman has been tenacious to start this second half. And this possession here, it's led to a foul there. This is the contact coming in from Jules. And you're seeing maybe the indication of the hand getting up from Miles Thompson into the face area. That it was the contact of the two wheelchairs that led to this, the restart. But Freeman has been outstanding to start in this second half. She's been great and the leader so far in the match for GB, but Conroy hasn't been able to quite find her sights as yet in this third quarter. And the blocking foul against Great Britain And she's been busy so far now, has Celine Villard in this second portion of the game. Freeman so capable with her mobility, agility, and switching of the hands so fast. The pass to get into Ouellette is intercepted. It's Williams who just gets a touch of it. Trying to control into their tallest option. What a shot from the outside. Thinking of just trying to shield it from the defenders and then launching a shot there. So much core strength and to deliver that shot towards the net. The feed right from the top of the key. Gonna have to just get a little bit more momentum behind it is Charlotte Moore. 17 years of age. And a level 1.0, her classification. Speed from Ouellette, and it's one of her weapons too. Really Ouellette's and her opposite number, Freeman. The two pitting up against each other in this one. McGrath attracting Conroy again. They're the two taller players for their sides. And McGrath just forced back. 5 seconds on the shot clock. And in to action. Canada with the 5-point margin with that good steady bit of control. And as response, again, Great Britain just keeping it within range. Their shooting percentage is faltering ever so slightly as this match is unfolding, but that fast break and well taken from Williams. Needing some support, the quick hands from Freeman have led this one up to Ouellette, and Ouellette will just put it in the bottom of the basket again. And she's now starting to really find her form in this matchup. Very powerful, but very quick. And her and Freeman are really the catalyst offensively for their respective sides. But this is just reaching in on the arm. The Canadians with the foul against, it'll be an inbound as the referee, Celine Villard, is waiting for players to get into position. 14 points, as you see, the rebounds and the assists. So a well-balanced game from Ouellette. See the strapping on her shoulder. Just reinforcement more than anything to feel comfortable. So much work going in, obviously, in those areas. Just wanting to feel as settled. And if there is any irritation in that shoulder, they get a great favorable rebound here, does Freeman, and comes right back in the lane, and the Canadians will get back into position. They're just trying to get the give and go into Love, and it's the foul already, incidental contact before the attempt at the shot. And Canada now with 5 points clear, the chance to further increase the scoreline. They're just trying to lock up. The good defensive work there of Conroy, but a lot of this picking that goes on off of the ball up in the court area. It'll be just a shot that can't quite get the distance there. And GB, these are the real swing points in the game when you're down by five, maybe can increase the lead to seven, and then you make a basket and try to bring it within three, but not with that particular look. So they're the overall team percentages in the shots, 33% for Great Britain and 41 for Canada. That shot clock is inching down. It goes off the rim, which will give them another 24, but it's quickly taken from Great Britain. Poised, set to shoot. And again, just a little too hard at the moment. And those are the small details, a little bit of difference That is the big difference on the scoreline, but the fallen GB athlete awaiting to come into the match. This is Amanda Yan. She's a 3.0, 28 years of age. Her first action now to replace her teammate, and that's Rosalie Lalonde that will now go out. She's the youngster, the teenager, 19 years of age. So using the full depth, it's a long tournament. And every player of the 12 that are in the lineup, you try your best in which to use them, but obviously they've been leaning heavily on this lady here. Janet McLaughlin into the center key area. That one will go off the rim. And GB into the very reliable hands of Freeman. She will bring it up, and it's the Love now. Love trying to spin around. She with the bandana. Very confident coming on is Love. And over to Conroy, and Conroy will rattle it around, but find a way in which to get it to the bottom of the basket. Really is a tough defense against McLaughlin. So tall, and that size advantage in that center area. Aggressively coming forward, and almost the speed a little too much there, working against Great Britain. Canada pick up the leftovers, and can they convert this loose change into a real Canadian dollar here? Put this on the board and get that 5-point margin again. Oh my, what a shot there. Almost just launched from the side winding position. And it's that trajectory sometimes that is what prevents maybe the ball having a chance to fall. It'll just hit the front of the rim and work away. So much there, a little bit more arc on that shot from Freeman, and gives that ball a chance to go in, but it's just off the rim and out. Inside of 2 minutes now of this third quarter of play, and here comes Ouellette. She of the black headband. And she'll shoot from anywhere. If she gets a look, she is confident enough to stop and pop. Feeding it around to Yan. Yan with her first attempt at a bucket today. And Freeman down that far sideline is just going to work into the corner. So busy and so agile there with the movement and the passing game. It's her awareness there that really is the key that unlocks this Canadian defense. And this game now back within one, as both sides just getting a measure of each other now, but equally Canada have that big threat on the inside. Janet McLaughlin, not only does she have the size, but she has a level of function as a 4.5, which is to her credit and Canada's advantage. She really can make the most of that, and particularly with the complement of her enhanced size over all the other athletes on the floor, it's a significant asset for Canada. Inside the last minute now, they'll just wind their way across the line. And it will be GB coming up with it for Freeman. She would like a last shot to bring this match within one. It was within one at halftime. Will it be the same at the end of three quarters of play? The offload to Conroy. She tries to attempt to restart. All of that movement she's able to deliver just through her core. And the shot from the outside, the shot clock just sounding ahead of the release. Play will be allowed to continue. And that's the end of the seconds remaining. And Canada have just pushed a little further ahead now after the three quarters. They have a 3-point margin now by winning that period 10-8. It's now a scoreline of 35-32, Canada over Great Britain. And there you see confirmation of it. The Canadians 3 points up after three quarters of play over Great Britain. And the shooting percentage, still just the one free throw in the match, that belonging to McLaughlin. It was in the second quarter, but the defensive rebounds really starting to tally up, but both sides keeping each other in check. Just a little bit of a favorable shooting advantage for Canada so far, but this crowd enjoying it, well energized by the spirit, not only in the building, but obviously on the field of play as well. Both of these teams starting strong and not really needing a second invitation in which to get off the mark in this match at all, as both sides giving as good as they get. And some outstanding play so far. Really, the leadership coming from Freeman from Great Britain, and equally Houlette and McLaughlin for Canada. So wheelchair basketball coming into the Paralympic Games in 1960 in Rome. And, oh, it's going to be a quick start for GB. That was the men's side of the tournament, however. The women coming along within the decade later. But this is the advancement of the ball from Canada. Now a point up. And this has every feeling that it may require the possibility of extra time. That one point, that free throw shot, has been differential now for the best part of 5-7 minutes in this match. And could that be a part to tell? It's the only free throw that has been taken. You expect that there will be more as we get to the closing stages of this match. But it is McLaughlin who's down. She's up right now. And the foul called on the play, but obviously not in the course of shooting. And the Canadian coaching staff, Bill Johnson, the head coach, assistant coach Michael Broughton, and you didn't see her there, but Katie Miyazaki. And for Canada, taking that right under their own basket in good position, anticipating where that rebound might come to. But you're seeing a couple of these fouls here where the play getting a little bit more aggressive in these channels as they're trying to carve routes up the floor. You're looking at the veteran of this Canadian side, their seventh Olympic or Paralympic Games, rather. She's also a competitor in other sports as well in the athletics prior in her Paralympic career. It's Tracy Ferguson, but this is Harnock on the floor right now. The offload, the long pass in, does well. Such great body control. And if this goes too, that's just more impressive. But she can't quite get the roll of it. It's just off the front of the rim, but she will, in fact, get another 24 seconds on the shot clock. It just goes off. Steves there on the bench for Canada. And this just needing to keep those two front wheels beyond the baseline, but Canada reloading. Nulette with the offload. This much more confident and more fluid from Katie Harnock. She's trying to give this Canadian offense a third dimension. So Harnock has a couple, Jules has a couple points. But the other 31 belong to McLaughlin and Ouellette. And here is McLaughlin back to take it. Settling forward to her running mate, Ouellette. And these two really set the table. In and the contact before she even receives the ball. And that's the two threats for Great Britain. Conroy and Freeman trying to double team Janet McLaughlin. And there is the aforementioned Katie Miyazaki, the assistant coach for Canada, on the bench there in the black glasses. And that will go off the rim. And will there have been contact prior to change this inbound? So much work now going on off the ball. And it is bringing about a little bit of urgency from both sides. Each play and each possession, obviously building towards what will be the end result in this one, in the fourth quarter of play now. And the player marking going on all over the court. Through the middle is Freeman. Freeman's going to have to hold up. She's gone right into the heart of the Canadian defense. Into three Canadian maple trees, and she doesn't come up with a sap. It will be now the possession for Ouellette. And often left the field of play, the upended Canadian. They're going to allow play to continue. She'll work herself into a good position. And then the referee just saying, listen, I'll call the game. You worry about the whistle. And if there is none, then play continues. And Ouellette offers her apologies, and it was important just to let everybody find their level in the opener and see just how things will be adjudicated. This, the feed in. Oh, that's a great score for Canada. A little bit of dimension as Jules will put up her second bucket. That's Jamie Jules now with 4 points in the match. And those are the small differences that could tally at the end. The 1 point difference is the only free throw we've seen from McLaughlin in this entire match. And that's why it's not on even numbers for Canada, because everything has been of a 2 point variety. This for Ouellette. To move it on. And the patience again is going to go to the consistent hand. Will they take a shot from there? They do. Canada almost find a way. And the confidence that had come from the shot once prior from Jules, she can't quite get the accuracy, but Conroy, she is very lengthy. She finds the angle, not only the height advantage too. You see the way her chair sits. It's also really poised for that type of play, being elevated and being a tall option for Great Britain. You see how athletic she is with her speed and so well coordinated to try and pull up and get that shot, but it's just a little too hard and off the glass. She'll get a couple shots now from the free throw line. And she misses the first one. And it's picked up by Freeman. Not a lot of spin or rotation on those shots, but that really needed to be a basket for GB. They can't cash it in. And here comes Canada in the break, and you see the expression from the British coach. That is so well taken with the right hand, curving away from the play. The underload there to the tall Janet McLaughlin, and she will be fouled. But there is the indication prior to that that leads. It is the foul against Canada that leads to Freeman taking the inbound here now. It's just exceptional to take that ball and almost bundle it into your side, and then equally need to keep pushing and keep your speed going to make sure you don't travel with it. And GB have just lost their sights a little bit here as far as their accuracy of shooting in and around the basket. And that is leaving an opening for Canada to really exploit. McLaughlin, just the loft in, is just a little too close to the rim underneath it. And Ouellette forces it loose and it jars forward, but Conroy just carving away now through the middle of the floor and across this three-point line. Would just hold up and wait for some support. She threatens to make the pass to the inside. This just needing to be careful here. Freeman has done it. Freeman was out of bounds when she had touched it on the second search for possession. It's Canada and a timeout now in the fourth quarter. 5:13 remaining. They have the 3-point margin over Great Britain in what has been a seesaw back and forth. And this the two of three taken from GB in the second half already. Needs the timeouts and the discussion going on. It's as much for a breather, but now for some instruction. Miles Thompson just talking about a little bit more offensive control from Great Britain, not rushing the shot. They have looked a little bit hurried in their last few possessions, and that's giving a little bit of a sense maybe of offensive panic to their game. They don't need to be doing that. The score line is within check. And it's just about keeping calm in the moment. Canada with the inbound. To Katie Harnack. She'd love another basket before this one's out. That could be decisive. McLaughlin, the offload. Is this in to Harnack? And the shot will go up. That was Rosalie Lalonde with the attempt there. And this now, free throw shots for her. And Lalonde. A teenager, 19, stares at the front of the rim for what would be her first point of this match. And it's just a little too solid, both attempts that'll come out and beyond. So Canada giving back this daylight for Great Britain to get level on a score. Now, 3 points would be a little ambitious, you might think, but at least 2 points with this possession here. Freeman is going to set and look for it. And she's run out of time there on the shot clock. And the change for Canada, and up and over it will come. So just to clarify, yes, of course, it needs to hit the rim in order to reset the shot clock. Into the key area, and the fallen GB athlete. Freeman is doing her best to watch every move that Ouellette is bringing to the table now. Cindy Ouellette, she will be the go-to to control it, but some real smooth ball handling here from Katie Harnack. It's just valuable possession. The shot clock is running out, but the back coming in, and if that had fallen, it's heavily impressive, but the shot clock does sound, but it's irrelevant as the possession's already with GB coming up the floor. Great Britain looking, and Freeman, they've just lost their mark right now. They look as though they are a side that has in fact been snake bitten offensively. And you see the coach appealing to them, Miles Thompson, try and calm them down, but they have just lost the offensive confidence you need at this stage of a match. Lalonde couldn't take either of those shots from the free throw line. And now into control. The feed, Lalonde, the offload, and this, another look. Oh, do they work it, and they do it well. Katie Harnack, I say she needed really another basket, and that could prove telling as Canada have now gone up by five. And Freeman, who's gone a little bit cold with their shot making, It'll be Conroy that needs to come up with it, and then Conroy looks a little forced. The long play up, and it's a fast break from Canada again to Ouellette. Ouellette, oh, and she's unable to convert. And that really would have, you sense, been decisive potentially. Canada up by seven, but they don't convert it, and they stay with the 5 points to their credit. But then the foul off the play. And that goes against the Canadians, as it will be Freeman with the inbound. The give and go, so she can take it and really drive forward. Her speed is of the best on the floor. For Conroy, she's just asking her to come back and support. Maybe give her a little bit of a pick because she's being forced out. The Canadians are not giving any quarter inside that key area. From the outside, it goes around the rim, and it will just get away from Great Britain. And the change of possession, Canada will have the inbound. Now you listen to the bilingual nation that is Canada, both French and English, official languages. And Ouellette, of French-speaking origin, with this for Canada. A little bit of a hitch in waiting for Cindy Ouellette to come up and to support the play. She comes over the feed there, and this is the shooting game, and McLaughlin has done it again. She's now with 19 points in the game. She leads the entire performance of either team individually. Freeman has 14 for GB. So this looking ominous now for Great Britain. 7 points back. And again, another shot just will not go. And the pressure and the stress for Great Britain that they've maybe just not come up with enough. And that will just go across the face of the rim. It's Conroy to come back once more and try and tidy up. And are they going to count that one in continual motion, or was the whistle blown? So you keep seeing shots there. Tracy Ferguson, and she's not been in the lineup. She's the 42-year-old veteran of this Canadian side, four-time gold medal Paralympian for Canada. And they did it in the years 92, 96, 2000, and in Athens as well. And she is a stalwart. But she's not been in the lineup at the moment. And the Canadians, the older of the two sides, 29 years of age is the average. For Great Britain, they're much more youthful. Just under 23 years of age. But this is Conroy from the line. And she gets the favor of the touch of the rim up off the glass, and it will drop. And two for two. An important couple points there. It really is going to need to be special, though, from Great Britain. Maybe even a three-point attempt, which would really be asking a lot to expect that to be converted. But a timeout now been utilized once again inside the last minute of the fourth quarter. And it's the Canadians this time electing to employ it. And they just need to settle down their side with this five-point advantage they should expect from themselves to be able to see this out from here. That's a look at the shot from their powerful center, Janet McLaughlin. Skill, size, and height. They're really to her advantage. She attracts immediately the two defending GB athletes to double team her. And she's now is poised onto that free throw line. She'll have a couple shots. Looking for some personnel adjustments going on over at the sidelines in front of the respective benches. The Canadians with a little bit of hopeful optimism and positivity, just waiting for this clock to count down. And a couple shots here they would love to record and put back on. You can see some of the querying going on from Bill Johnson, the Canadian coach, just wondering and needing some clarity from the referees. No time wasted there from Janet McLaughlin as she will put the first of two in. And the sixth point, it's an even half dozen lead inside this last minute. And she has been perfect from the line today. Goes up and over 20 points, 21 total. The leader in the match, and now they're arm in arm on the Canadian bench, anticipation of the final horn in this one. They're gonna need to stand strong and hold strong in this last sequence. And that one is a rather hopeful shot that will just leave the field of play, and it will be a Canadian possession just as quickly back in their control. And Hamar will come in. She gets the opportunity to get some valuable seconds, and every player wanting to get themselves started in the Rio Paralympic Games. And this may be here late a little bit. She was utilized to foul as the inbound. So that was a tactical decision, making sure not to have one of the other athletes who may be on foul trouble. So she comes in and does her job and delivers this stoppage of the clock. And now Ouellette will take advantage with a shot there, but she doesn't make the first one. And it just gets away. So you talk about the rebounding equally of McLaughlin today, 21 total rebounds for Canada. 20 defensively, one offensive rebound, just a dominant display. 21 points in total so far, five assists as Conroy just runs out. There's another defensive rebound for McLaughlin all the way up. It's gonna be Ouellette at the other end. She doesn't need to rush it. She's gonna try and control this out now. And she'll put it back to her teammate as these two yin and yang for Canada will see out the remaining seconds. And that will, in fact, be it. It'll finish the first match of the wheelchair basketball, the women's Group A in the preliminary round. And Great Britain versus Canada. It is Canada who will record the victory. And this display from that woman there, their veteran of the side, 39 years of age, and she did it all, offensively, defensively, and distributing the ball as well. And equally so did her running mate there as well, Cindy Ouellette, who had 14 points. She had six assists, six rebounds as well. And those two really set the table for Canada in their opening matchup in this group, as both sides will shake hands. And due respect afforded all across the sport, but equally these two longtime adversaries as well. A Commonwealth Classic will in fact fall in favor of Canada. 43-36 over Great Britain. That is the full-time result in women's wheelchair basketball.